Hello and welcome to this first section of this course. If you are familiar with the matrices, you can skip this section. If you know what is a matrix and what are the basic types of matrices and some basic commands in Scilab, I will not be showing many commands of Scilab in this first lecture. I will be just explaining some key points about matrices, because Scilab is based on matrices. And if you do not have a solid foundation in matrices, then you will be struggling in this course. For those who are very beginners, who are not very much familiar, or maybe they have taken a course in matrices for a very long time, so this section will be a good and very quick review. So let's get started. What is a matrix? Matrix is simply an arrangement of numbers. So these numbers could be coming from any background information. You might have an Excel sheet, or you might have data somewhere stored in any database. But as far as definition is concerned, a matrix is simply a table of numbers, or you can say a 2D array of numbers. So you can define a matrix however you like. Now, matrix is denoted by a square bracket here on both sides of numbers. And these numbers are called elements or entries of a matrix. So this is the row of a matrix. So this is first row, this is second row, and this is third row. Similarly, this is the first column, and there are three columns. So their elements resides in a row and in a column. And this is the general description of a matrix. So we describe matrix generally in mathematics in this formation. So this means that element A resides in first row and first column. The first digit in the subscript shows the row in which this element resides, and the second digit shows the column. For example, this element is in second row and second column. So if a matrix has an equal number of rows and columns, for example, this matrix has three rows and three columns. So if the rows and columns are equal, then the matrix is called square matrix. And if this is not the case, then the matrix is called a rectangular matrix. This definition is important sometimes, because these square matrix are of much more interest for us. But we also use these rectangular matrix. Now, these are some of the key points about matrices. The first thing is the order of a matrix. So order of matrix is simply described as the number of rows multiplied by the number of columns. So if a matrix has two rows and three columns, the order will be 2 multiplied by 3. If a matrix is square, you can say the square matrix of order 3, because square matrix have both number of rows and number of columns equal. So you can describe it with one number. So the second thing is element, which I already have described, matrix addition. So when we say matrix addition and multiplication, there are some conditions for addition and multiplications. So for addition, the condition is that if you want to add two matrices, the both of those matrix should have same order. So if one matrix has an order of 2 multiplied by 3, the other matrix must be of the same order. They must not, it's not a requirement that they should be square matrix, but their order should be same. So because each and every element of first matrix will be added to the corresponding element in the second matrix. Now, when it comes to multiplication, there are two important points. The first important point is that multiplication of A with B, AB, is not necessarily, in most of the cases, it's not equal to B multiplied by A. These two are totally different situations, and sometimes AB is possible, but BA is even not possible. So this is the first point. And why it is so? Due to this second point. Because the condition for multiplication is that if you are multiplying two matrices A and B, the number of column of the first matrix, which is occurring first, you see the number of columns of the first matrix must be equal to the number of rows of the second matrix. If you are getting a product of B multiplied by A, then you will see the columns of C and rows of A. you always see the columns of the first matrix. For example, this matrix, this is a very interesting matrix. As you can see that this matrix has four columns, 1, 2, 3, 4. And this column has four rows. So if I want to multiply AB, so how many columns A have? 4. And how many rows B have? 4. So I can get this product. And we will talk about this, how to do the multiplication in the next lecture. But at this lecture, it's only we are looking at the conditions, whether AB is possible or not. Now, what about BA? In BA, we have to look how many columns B have. B have only one column. And how many rows A have? A have only one row. So BA is also possible. So in this situation, as you can see that AB and BA both are possible for this type of matrix. And if a matrix has only one row, it is also called a row matrix. It is also called a row matrix, or sometimes you can call it a row vector. Similarly, if a matrix is only of one column, you can call it column matrix or column vector. So this row vector and this column vector can be multiplied in both directions, AB and BA. Other than that, if the both of the matrix are square matrices of the same order, for example, 3 cross 3 or 4 cross 4, if both are 3 cross 3, 3 cross 3, then both can be multiplied in both directions. The next thing is a very simple concept I wanted to highlight here, that if you want to multiply a matrix with a constant value, so the resultant would be that this constant would be multiplied with each and every element of the matrix. Now, next thing is transpose of a matrix. So transpose of a matrix, for example, A is a matrix. This is a matrix A, very simple matrix, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 9. So if you make a first row as a first column, and the second row as a second column, and the third row as a third column, then the matrix which you will get is called the transpose of the matrix. And this is denoted by A transpose or A dash or A prime, whatever you call it. Now, this is another example of transpose. As you can see that in this case, we have our first matrix, which has an order of 2 multiplied by 4, 2 rows and 4 columns. If you take the transpose of this matrix, so the first row will become first column and the second row will become second column. Now the order will be 4 into 2. So the order will be changed. So let us see how we can use our knowledge of matrices at this stage in Scilab. So at this stage, we don't know much about matrices, but we know two things. One is that we know how to make a matrix. And the second thing is what is a transpose of a matrix. So we will use these two things. So how to make a matrix in Scilab? So in Scilab, for example, I want to make a matrix A, which has 3 rows. 1, 2, 3 is in the first row, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9 in the third row. So I will do like this. A equals square brackets. Then there are two ways. The first way is you make first element, then space, second element, space, third element, and semicolon to end the row. Then the first element of the second row, space, second element, space, third element, then end the row with a semicolon. And then 7 space 8 space 9 and close the square bracket, and you will get the matrix A. So this is your one way to define a matrix. The second way to define a matrix is that you use comma instead of space. So A can be defined, let's say we define B. B equals, let's say, the same matrix. So 1, 2, 3 semicolon, 4, 5, 6 semicolon, 7, 8, 9, and then close the square bracket. So this is your matrix B. Because both matrix have same order, so we can add them. So let us say C is their sum. So C equals A plus B. So it will add the corresponding elements of both matrices. The first element in the first row and first column will be added in first row and first column. So you will get 2. Similarly, 2 will be added to 2. You will get 4. And you can see that this matrix can be formed. So this is the addition of both matrices. Now, what about transpose? Because we also know how to transpose a matrix. We have not learned the multiplication, but we know how to transpose a matrix. What is a transpose of a matrix? So let's make a transpose. So for transpose, the command is, if you want to transpose matrix A, you simply type A apostrophe and enter. And as you can see here, that the first row of A has become the first column of this A transpose. And because we have not assigned any variable to this, so this is stored in a variable answer. So if you want, for example, D as the A prime matrix, so you can say D equals A prime. Now you will get this matrix D, which is the transpose of matrix A. So this is how you transpose a matrix. So at this stage, we only have learned so much. So, but there are many commands in Scilab which deal with the matrices and which we will be learning in our next lectures.